Hi, my fellow YouTubers. We're at the Body Design Studio in Hillcrest with the lovely Simone Amber Falvik. Simone, you're a pole dancer, and by the amount of certificates on this wall, I'd say you're quite talented. You recently did provincials. Are you satisfied with yourself?
I am, and thank you. With the provincials, we have to dance, and there's a certain scoring system. And I came second, so I'm very happy with that, and professional, which was really cool.
Nice.
So I'm quite happy, and with my progress, especially in this year, I'm very happy.
Done. Of course, everyone has to start somewhere. Like, how did you get into the sport?
It was on Groupon. So there was a voucher, and it was half price, and my mom started, but I carried on. So that's how I did this.
You're sitting here, I know you permanently have bruises on your legs and on your body. Is it a dangerous sport?
Yes, I have bruises, but it's not a dangerous sport at all. There are certain things that could make it dangerous and you would think it is, but if you have the right instructor and a good spotter, someone to help you, and mattresses, which you recently got, then it's okay. But there are times when you can fall off the pole. It has happened before, but it's not a dangerous sport. I mean, we've had one person end up in a wheelchair and paralyzed, but that was because the rigging broke, not because she fell off the pole. So.
Okay, so I'm certain like any other sport, there are moves that you love and then moves that you certainly hate. What is the moves that you hate and how do you motivate yourself to do them?
There are a lot of moves where you need to use your armpit and your elbow to hold on the pole. I do not like those. I hate them with a passion, and every time my instructor tells me to do them, I still nod my head and say, not going to do that. But we, as an instructor, we have to teach our class to do it, so I know that if I practice them and I just get on with it, then my students will be able to do them and not take on my weakness. So they'll turn my weakness into a strength.
Watching the Olympics, I saw there was a male category. Is the sport for a specific gender, age, or...?
Definitely not. We have, in this class, no males, but at the places in South Africa and all over the world, it's definitely for males. Also, all sizes and all ages. We have someone in our studio who is 50 years old, and we have as young as 7. And all body shapes and all sizes, young, old, tall, short, whatever, and definitely males.
I'm dying to know, how do you do it? You're currently studying for a degree through UNISA, you're an intern at a junior primary school, you're an intermediate pole instructor, and then you have to do your own classes. How do you do it?
It's difficult, but when you do what you love, it sort of doesn't feel like you're actually doing anything at all. So yes, I'm at the studio every single night and almost every morning, but I love what I do, so it's motivation enough for me to just keep going.
Being on the topic of instructing, we all know that pole dancing has a huge stereotype attached to it. How do you get people to start and get comfortable?
Well, I always tell people that they mustn't knock us until they try it. So if someone is hesitant to come, I'll just say, just come try a class, see how you feel. I don't force them to do anything. So when they get here, generally people are a little bit shy, but once they see that everyone is doing it, that no one's afraid to be humiliated, then they're generally okay. With regards to clothing, obviously you need to wear as little as possible, because the less clothes you wear, the more safe it is, because you need your skin. So that takes a while for people to get used to it. Once they realize that, and once they see that everyone is doing it, it's not just them, then they get comfortable.
You still like to achieve in the sports line?
There's a lot I would like to achieve, so there's many, many moves that I would like to do. Flips off the pole are one of my goals. Otherwise, I would like to be in the top of South Africa for this sport, and if possible, go to Worlds.
So right, in conclusion, is there anything you'd like to add to potential holders and our viewers?
When I first invite people to come, I tell them what it's all about. Okay, it helps boost your confidence, it helps work with cardio, it helps you tone, helps with endurance and balance. And also, we always say that laughter is the best medicine, because we always laugh in class.
Wow. treat, Simona's agreed to give us a small preview of her dance routine. So this is me signing off. Thanks guys for watching.
Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days.